What's up, guys? It's Coach Grant with First Down Training, and today we're going to be breaking down how wide receivers can run a dig route versus off-man coverage, okay? So I hope this video helps you out. I hope it teaches you a few ways to attack off-man coverage when the DB's outside shade, head up, or even inside shade. But also, fellas, if you guys have not heard, we're going to be coming out to 9 different cities this offseason for our 2-day quarterback, wide receiver, and DB training camp tour, okay? So we're going to be coming into 9 different locations, and to be honest with you guys, these are not going to be camps where it's like 100, 200 different kids where you're only getting about 5 reps every single hour. It's going to be very small numbers because we really would like to focus on the details and actually teaching you guys. So many camps, you get guys that go out there and it's just they're not teaching anything. It's just getting guys through the drills, getting guys through the drills. That's not what we're trying to do. The groups are going to be very small, about 8 to 10 kids per grouping, and we're splitting it up into youth and high school, so you're always going to be working with somebody your age. So check out that very first link in the description below if you guys are local to the Tampa, Florida area, Houston, Texas area, Phoenix, Arizona, Newark, New Jersey, Atlanta, Georgia, Nashville, Tennessee, Chicago, Illinois, Dallas, Texas, and Los Angeles. We're coming to all those locations this offseason. So if you guys want to get some great work in, some great detailed one-on-one small group coaching, check out that very first link below if you're located near those areas. Let's get started with this video. So first things first here, when we look at this route, DB is where? He's outside shade, right? So what does that mean to us? Why is this DB outside shade? This is KJ Hillier at the Senior Bowl from Ohio State. Now, this DB is probably outside shade because they're working a situation where he has safety help, right? It's one-on-one, so obviously there's no safety there. But again, DBs work these situations so they're a little bit more disciplined in this type of coverage when they actually do have safety help, right? It's like almost a form of resistance training in a way. So as a receiver, we have to treat it that way as well. We can't just go take off and just go run to the inside and take what he gives me. Treat it realistic. You guys got to take one-on-ones, routes versus air, 7-on-7. You got to treat those situations realistic because it's all about getting better. These one-on-one situations, it's about work. It's not about looking cool. It's not about doing the fancy move that takes 8 hours. It's about making an efficient move and getting up into the route so it translates into an actual game time scenario, okay? So now, when I have a DB who's outside shade, we know he's trying to force me inside, trying to force me to that safety. So when I come off the line of scrimmage, if I got to run an in route, I can't just take what he gives me and run the in route because he's going to get right into my hip pocket and it's going to be a very tight window for the quarterback. So I have to threaten him where he doesn't want me to go. He's outside shade because his job is to protect the outside. So what Hill does a great job of here is attacking him outside. So that DB is going to do what he's taught to do when he's outside leverage is keep the outside leverage. He's going to keep his leverage. He's going to move to the outside. He's going to weave with me. But guess what that opens up? That opens up all kinds of space right here. Like let's say this safety is somewhere like around this Nike sign, right? If I were to just take off and just go run, that safety would be all over it and that DB would be all over it and the quarterback has a very tight window to throw, right? But because I worked him off the platform, DB is still, this safety is still at this Nike sign, but look at the window that I just created for myself simply because I angled my stem to the outside, right? Now, the other important thing though when you angle this stem to the outside is we can't break this thing off and then just go run straight to the zone. We have to push up vertical. I have to get this DB to flip his hips because again, the same thing applies, the same principle applies in terms of getting separation. Everything is a fade until we get up to the depth of the route, right? So we move him off the platform, give him that shake, and Hill does a great job of pushing vertical, selling like I'm running a seam, selling like I'm running a corner route maybe, like gonna take this thing up at the higher angle, but hips and shoulders stay committed to this break point until that last second. Because again, if I can get this DB to bite on the fade, that's just more separation for myself, more space for that quarterback to fit this thing in a tight window. When you have that inside breaking route against outside shade, it could be very easy to just wanna take off and go get there. And again, zone, that's probably what you should do. But when it's off man like this, off man situation, there's one high safety, we see DB's outside shade. He's giving us man eyes. He's looking at me. He's not looking at the quarterback. I got to work him outside, then take what he gives me, right? And then it would be the opposite. Like, let's say if he was inside shade, right? Like, this DB was inside shade and you had to run a dig. You'd want to attack his outside shoulder if he was inside shade because you attack the outside shoulder. You get this DB to flip his hips like we did on the inside portion of this dig. Then we can slip underneath, right? So it's all about understanding that leverage when you're running this dig against off man coverage inside, outside shade. And then if he's head up, let's go step on his toes. Let's give him a move. Probably working to attack the outside shoulder if the spacing of the play allows it. Let's watch it full speed one more time. Great job attacking him off that platform. Great job pushing vertical and then getting out of this route efficiently. All right, guys, we want to thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. If you guys have any questions at all, please don't hesitate to leave those in the comment section below. We'll get back to you as soon as I possibly can. Always appreciate the feedback. Always appreciate what you guys have to say. And again, fellas, if you guys are located in any one of those 9 cities, Tampa, Florida, Houston, Texas, Phoenix, Arizona, Dallas, Texas, Newark, New Jersey, Chicago, Illinois, Nashville, Tennessee, Los Angeles, California, any of those cities or states, check out that very first link below if you want to come out and get some work in with us. Again, spots are limited, so they're going to fill up at some point, probably here pretty quick before the holidays. So very first link below. I'll see you guys next time.